before.
Welcome to Armchair Directors. I'm Michael Mercy.
And I'm Matthew Crandall.
And with Predators new on Blu-ray, we've decided to go back and review the classic John McTiernan Predator movie, also available on Blu-ray. You were telling me that there's two versions of this on Blu-ray.
So there are. This is the good version with film grain and sadly no extras, but they've just brought out in the summer an Ultimate Hunter Edition that is loaded with extras. But they have used a digital noise reduction process on the movie that scrubs away all the film grain so it looks really clean. But when you do that, it makes everything have no fine detail. So watching it, you feel like you're watching something through a Vaseline-covered lens. And half the time, Arnold and them look like wax figures or almost like a Scanner Darkly animation. It is really horrible.
Rotoscoping. Yeah, the grain isn't bad on this at all.
Stay away from the Ultimate Hunter Edition. Fox ruined it.
Yeah, the image on this is still fantastic. Being that most of the movie is in the jungle, it actually adds to the whole gritty, hot
for sure
feel of it. And it's old enough to be forgivable.
Yeah.
Movies from the 80s are going to have a little bit of grain. But it really does look exceptional. I mean, there's movies from the 80s that look terrible. Like Lethal Weapon just looks like a DVD transfer.
It does.
Lethal Weapon Blu-ray. This is one of the really good ones. So Predator, the one that started it all, starring Arnold Schwarzenegger. And I feel like this was the one that really solidified Arnold as a major real deal big box office star.
For sure.
He had a few between, like Terminator was the one that kind of started to really solidify him. Conan was the one that introduced him to us. Then Terminator. He did a couple of throwaway actioners, raw deal probably.
Commando.
But this was his trifecta of larger than life, awesome action characters.
He was basically, you know, one of these first big summer blockbuster type movies that he was the draw.
Yeah.
So even when they like marketed it, they were like, "Come and see Arnold in the jungle." And there's something in the jungle, but it wasn't like you were coming to see a sci-fi movie just to see a sci-fi movie. You were coming to see an Arnold movie.
Yeah, like they could have easily marketed it as come and see the Beast.
Right.
Right, because that's how Aliens had been marketed. And even though Arnold was the Terminator, it was more about that metal endoskeleton that was underneath the Arnold skin than Arnold himself. So it's pretty cool that even on this case, it's just Arnold.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and maybe the Predator is like, I can't tell if he's blended in there, but yeah.
And basically, you know, it was directed by McTiernan, who then went on
Die Hard.
Great streak with Die Hard, and he's just done tons of action movies from there on out.
Yeah, and he's kind of disappeared, unfortunately.
He's serving 1 year in jail right now.
Really? I didn't know
for,
that.
For wiretaps and other illegal activities.
Oh my goodness.
Although I just like to think that he's serving 1 year in jail for Rollerball.
That would...
Which was terrible.
That would be justice.
So, Predator, classic.
Yep, and the rest of the team. Let's not let Arnold overshadow everybody else on the team.
Carl Weathers,
Apollo Creed, is really cool, despite being oiled up far too much for most of this movie.
Yeah.
And then we got Jesse the Body Ventura as Blaine with the classic old painless minigun.
Yeah.
Short but sweet little cameo. Well, a little bit bigger than a cameo role in this movie. And then Sonny Landham as Billy the big native tracker. So, in my opinion, it's Arnold, Blaine, Jesse Ventura, and Sonny Landham, Billy. The three of them that really make this one of the most badass movie teams ever in any movie, and it's why I keep putting this movie in year after year after year. Everyone on the team is cool. Like Hawkins is cool, but not on his own. And yeah, Poncho is cool, but not on his own.
Yeah.
But those three guys are the anchor of the team.
Yeah. And you know, one of the things about Predator is each guy has their own unique personality.
Yeah.
And there are lots of really great lines,
which they've kind of... That's what's so great about Predators is because they've really homaged not just the concept of humans being hunted,
yeah,
but also every guy having his own little personality and his own little quirks. Mm-hmm. They've really gone back to homaging the team in the original Predator with the new Predator.
For sure. And so, you know, that is one of the things I do like, the individual personalities and the really quick-witted dialogue. And a lot of that came from Shane Black, who's in the movie, and who also wrote Lethal Weapon. And they wanted him to be a writer on this, but they couldn't get his credit proper, so they cast him in the movie, and he was, like, feeding them dialogue on the set.
Oh, cool.
So, you know, very smart lines here and there. And Arnold is just awesome.
Yeah, fantastic. And the music by Alan Silvestri, who would, after this, go on to become one of the most legendary composers right alongside James Horner.
Yeah.
Timeless classic score, which makes a big return in Predators.
Yeah.
It's really cool that they've homaged a lot of his music, and very, very close homage, like a recreation. It's not sort of kind of the Predator theme in Predators, like happens in Terminator Salvation and Terminator 3. It's the old theme. It's in there, and it works just like it worked so well in the original. It works so well in Predators as well.
And I think what's cool about this movie is when it starts, you know, you're well into the movie before you even realize this is a science fiction movie.
Yeah.
Like, there's... Well, they set it up at the very beginning, but then all the stuff with Arnold and the team, this is just a bunch of guys in the jungle military movie.
Yeah.
And they've got some great action sequences.
They're on a Black Ops model.
And then it sort of turns the genre on its head, because suddenly they're battling this alien presence, and it becomes sci-fi and even more badass. But I think the reason it really works is because before it was just a straight-ahead Black Ops mission in the jungle kind of movie. And you aren't expecting it to go where it goes.
Yeah.
And then, it goes there so well.
Yeah, and the opening shot of the spaceship coming to Earth is just so quick and out there. It's like you don't even realize, you don't remember it as you're watching the movie.
And that's basically just to brace you for that when it comes back later, right? But if you were to come late to that movie and didn't even know what it was about,
you'd be like, what's going on?
You would have no idea when that Predator finally shows up. You'd be like, whoa.
Yeah.
Like,
I also like how the Predator, you never really get a good look at him until well into the movie.
Yeah.
Your first glimpses at him are the camouflage look, I can't do it really well, but the crackling sound, which, interesting bit of trivia, that piece of crackling vocal audio for the Predator is performed by Peter Cullen, the voice of Optimus Prime.
Yeah.
And a little story about when he recorded that, when he went into the sound booth and he did it and he left, McTiernan was apparently very upset because he was like, what did he do? He didn't do anything. I didn't hear anything. And then that was, you know, it's kind of funny. He
did ended up being the signature.
Yeah, the signature sound.
Yeah.
But I liked how it was a slower reveal with the Predator. And then even eventually when you do see him in all his glory, it's in the dark. He's moving quick. He's concealed in shadows and stuff. He's a man in suit. I love the man in suit.
And it's almost one of those happy accidents, because I've heard the stories of they were trying to work on another suit designed for the Predator, and it wasn't working. And they started filming the movie without having the actual suit that they wanted.
Yeah.
So they shoot a lot of it around the Predator, where you don't really see him, kind of like Jaws, where the shark never worked. And that's why Jaws is so good, is because you only see the shark when you absolutely need to. Just like this, you only see the Predator when you absolutely need to, because they were rushing production and they didn't have the suit ready to go.
Yeah.
And so it's like one of those perfect lightning in a bottle, sort of everything aligns, and you think that these are horrible production errors, and it ends up being for the better of your movie.
Mm-hmm. One of the problems I had with Predators was that sometimes you do see the Predators a little too clearly. It just, a few of the shots looked a little cheesy. You know, man in suit can be cheesy if it's lit too well and the shot, you see too much of it. They never make that mistake in this movie. Like, he's always jumping from trees.
The man in suit is very effective in this. And if you're going to fault anything in this movie, it's just time now has passed. And
some of the effects.
The him being invisible and his eyes lighting up and that kind of stuff aren't as believable as I'm sure they were back then. But they still look passable.
Yeah, and the heat vision, it's been cleaned up more in Predators. I kind of preferred it the old way, where there wasn't as much detail. In the new one, there is more detail. I like the fact that the Predator has all of these gadgets and these advantages, and he's got a big handicap that he's blind as a bat.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't really think they should have improved his vision at all. But, you know, that's personal choice.
Yeah. So I guess it's probably time for best part.
Worst part.
Well, do you bunk?
Heading down the highway, I haven't got a clue how I got in this car, baby.
Commander.
Why don't you kick us off with best part?
Best part is, it's going to come up in a second here on the menu. The part where Arnold Schwarzenegger, when he's preparing for the one-on-one battle with the Predator, he's got the torch, and he just starts slowly raising the torch to call out the Predator, and he lets out this primal scream. That moment right there is one of the most intense, raw moments that I've ever seen in any movie. A few years ago when I Am Legend was in pre-production and Arnold was set to star in I Am Legend, I read on Ain't It Cool News, the description was, this movie is going to be like that moment.
Right.
And you should have seen the talk back. Everyone was like, yes, that moment was awesome.
Yeah.
That moment was awesome. That's my best part of the whole movie. And the worst part is just how oiled up Carl Weathers is. I mean, the guy's in great shape, but my God.
Yeah. He was looking pretty greasy in some of those shots.
Yeah.
So my worst part would be Predator vision. And not that, you know, the effect is fine, but there are, like, long shots of Predator vision.
With the scorpion.
Where, like, 10 seconds would get us the idea, but we get, like, 90. And you're like, oh my God, back in 87, this must have been cool.
Yeah.
But now it's just like, please cut away. Like, cut to anything else. Because this doesn't look... It reminds me that it's an 80s movie. And then best part, you know, the action is fantastic. And I just love the moment where Arnold gets a good look at the Predator. And, you know, you won ugly motherfucker.
The Danny Glover line.
Yeah.
That Danny Glover made famous just, in part two.
Just awesome. the Predator laughing.
Yeah.
You know, the Predator laugh.
Especially when he's... That's the Sonny Landham laugh you're talking about, right?
Yeah.
The... Which if you go to Sonny Landham's website, that's what you hear. The first thing you hear is that eerie, creepy laugh followed by a nice, bubbly Sonny Landham's voice going, hello, I'm Sonny Landham.
But yeah, where he just... He's got that... The Predator's got that look on his face and he's, well, laughing Sonny Landham style.
Yeah.
That moment is just awesome.
So, yeah, with Predators new on Blu-ray, if you haven't seen the original Predator, definitely pick it up.
What are you waiting for?
Rent it. You know, buy it. Don't rent it. Buy it.
Buy it, but buy the one that looks like this. Got it? Get it. Good.
Thanks for watching.
Till next time.
Enjoy the show.
And you should know, what do you return? Since the first man you're facing, yeah. Well, I'm talking about people getting sad.